Hi everyone, it's Diana from Yang's Fitness Center. This 30-minute video is going to guide you through a yoga sequence focusing on our shoulders and our hips, which are two areas that many people have common tightness and problems with. So if you're ready, we're going to get started. You're going to grab a mat, a yoga mat preferably. I'm going to have you stand about 12 to 16 inches away from the very front end of your mat with your feet at hips distance apart. Rolling our shoulders down and back, standing as tall as you can. I'm going to ask that you close your eyes. And just notice that the weight of your body is equally into the four corners of both your feet. And with your next inhale breath, flipping your palms to the ceiling, allowing your arms to rise. And at the very top, as your palms touch, your exhale breath begins. So on the inhale breath, the palms are going to flip up towards the ceiling. Take a deep breath in. And at the very top, when your palms touch, exhale out. And just notice as you're performing this sequence that we have a very soft bend in our knees. We're taking our tailbone and slightly tucking that tailbone forward and underneath you, lengthening your lower back. Give me a couple more breaths, just like this. And you're slowly trying to match your inhales and your exhales. So it takes the same amount of time to inhale as it does to exhale. And our last one is coming now. And at the end of this exhale breath, placing your hands right at your heart center. And with your next inhale breath, gently open your eyes, gaze down into those fingertips. And as we inhale, turn the palms up towards the ceiling, lifting the chest. And as we exhale, sit back like you're sitting in a chair. And just notice in our chair, you want to rock your weight back into your hips and your heels, lifting your 10 toes. Take one more inhale breath here. And as we exhale, you're going to allow your hips to reach back, bend your knees softly, and let's just let your head drop. Shaking our head yes, and maybe no if that feels good. And if it feels better to you, taking those hands, hugging opposite elbows, and just drop your head. Take a couple more breaths here, lifting your hips up as high as you can, rooting down into both of your feet. And with our next inhale breath, allow our hands to drop down towards the floor. And we may choose to place our hands right on our shins, pull our chest forward and roll the shoulders back, lengthen the spine. If the floor is accessible, your hands might drop all the way down with your fingertips on the floor, with your chest still moving forward and your hips moving back. Take one more long inhale breath here. And as we lower our hands to the floor, take one foot and immediately step back. And once you step back, adjust your hands so they're shoulder distance apart, and then take the other foot all the way back. Come right down onto your knees. Align your knees so they're hips distance apart, and your shoulders, or your hands, excuse me, are about shoulder distance apart. About 1 inch right in front of your shoulders, you want your hands, and on your inhale breath, pull the chest forward, lift your chest. Take one more breath here, moving into your cow pose. And as we exhale, tuck your chin, press into the palm of your hands. Big arch in the upper back. Find your cat. Just let your head soften, let your neck soften. We'll flow through this a couple of times. On the inhale breath, lift the chest. Think about squeezing your elbows in, gently pushing those upper arms back. And as we exhale, push into the palms of your hands, including the index finger and the thumb. Big arch in the upper back. And give me two more just like that. On the inhale breath, come forward into your cow, relax your chin. And as we exhale, your cat. And we'll have one more just like that. And just noticing how your spine feels today. And at the end of your next exhale breath, find neutral spine. So neutral spine is neither cat nor cow. And as we tuck our toes underneath us, gently float your knees, keeping your hands and feet where they are. Slowly rock back, and as you rock back, bend your knees softly, push the mat away from you, and allow your head just to hang freely. Take one more long inhale breath here, lifting high onto your tippy toes, and as we exhale, bend one knee and gently lower the opposite heel. Take another inhale breath, come into your tippy toes, and now exhale, press the opposite heel down. Inhale, come high into the balls of both your feet. Tilt your tailbone slightly up, and now press those hips all the way back. And notice how the head should drop right between those elbows, And you're trying to straighten your arms, keeping the tailbone high. Gently press those heels down. Take one long inhale breath here. At the end of your exhale breaths, look forward. Take one foot, step it as far forward as you can. So most people are unable to bring their foot all the way to their hands, so not a problem. Take that foot, gently, gently slide the foot forward. Take the back foot, wiggle it back, as far back as you can, and then quietly drop that back knee down. So once you lower the knee, you're looking for the knee to line up right over the heel, and your hands, if you did not have any props, which I don't have today, can go on the inside of the leg, and gently squeeze this front knee towards your shoulder of the respective arm. So you're in a low lunge, trying to open up the back hip. Take one more inhale breath here, and if we need our hands, we might climb our hands onto that front knee and lift the chest. And once we lift the chest, the stretch is in the front of that back hip. So we have choices to stay right here, rolling our shoulders down and back, or we can extend our arms to the ceiling. We may or may not choose to interlace the arms, squeeze the elbows in, tucking our tailbone slightly underneath us, leaning slightly back. And our third option would be to lean a little bit towards the front leg. Take one more inhale breath here. And with our next inhale, coming back to center, placing both hands down. It could be on the outside or the inside of that front foot. Tuck your back toes under, pick up your back knee. Move this front foot forward so your hand replaces the foot, and gently step back. Find that downward facing dog again. And once you take a look at your hands and they're parallel to one another, shoulder distance apart, look at your feet, their hip distance apart, push the floor away from you. Take one more breath here. End of the exhales, we rock forward, coming to your high push-up. Roll the shoulders down and back, press those heels back, and I'm going to perform the first sun salute with our knees on the floor. So as I drop my knees and drop my shoelaces, squeezing the elbows in, gently lower the upper body towards the floor. Keeping the hands where they are, squeezing my legs together, tuck your elbows in, gently press down, and come into your low cobra, baby cobra. As you slowly lower the chest, keep the elbows squeezing in, stay on your knees, and push away from the floor. Tucking our toes, lifting our knees, we're gonna rock back to your downward facing dog. Take one more inhale breath here. Into the exhale, the other foot steps forward. So again, we're gonna try to move the foot so that the toes line up with the fingers. So we're gonna scoot that front foot forward, and we might move the back foot back. So you're trying to find length between the front heel and the back toes. So we drop down onto that back knee. We can keep both hands straddling the front foot, or we might move the hand to the inside and then squeeze the front knee against that front shoulder. And the whole time we're trying to pull our chest up and forward just like our cow and sink down into the hip of the back knee. Take one more breath here. And as we bring our hand to the outside, we're gonna tuck the back toes under. And then we're slowly coming up using our hands. Okay, if it's uncomfortable for you to tuck your toes, we can plant our shoelaces on the floor as we take a deep breath in. Softening the shoulders, tucking our tail, lifting our chest. We can stay here, interlace our hands, squeeze the elbows in. Or we can add a little bit of a side bend towards that front leg, opening up the hip flexor of that back leg. Take a long inhale here. And as we come back to center, releasing hands down, either outside or inside of that front foot, tuck your back toes under, lift the back knee, and we'll move this foot out to the side so the hand replaces the foot as we step back, checking our feet, their hip distance apart, checking our hands, their shoulder distance apart, and we press all the way back. Taking one long inhale breath here. Into the exhale, we have an option to stay here. Come down onto our knees for a cat and cow, or perhaps we're rocking forward for another vinyasa. Elbows squeeze in, chest forward, the last one we performed on our knees. We can do that again, or this time we're gonna try to stay on our toes. Bend our elbows, throw your heart forward, come into your low hover. Dropping your knees, dropping your toenails, squeeze the heels in. We come into our upward facing dog.
Taking one long inhale breath here.
And as you rock back, find your downward facing dog. Take one more long inhale. At the end of the exhale breath, we're gonna look forward, bend our knees. As you take one foot forward, the other foot follows. Checking that your feet are parallel, hips distance apart, drop your head, drop your shoulders, just relax here. At the end of the exhale, we find our inhale into our flat back. Fingertips can stay on the floor. They can be placed on our shins, they can be placed on our knees. The next inhale will take us all the way up to standing. Exhale, hands come to our heart. And as I turn sideways, just for illustration purposes, I'm gonna take your hands behind you. And as we bring our hands behind us, you're gonna find an interlace of your hands. And you're gonna slide those knuckles up towards your tag of your pants. And once we have the knuckles there, just relax your gaze and just relax your elbows. Allow those elbows to drop forward. And with your next inhale breath, keep your gaze where it is and pull those elbows back. And now relax the elbows forward. So imagine your arms were the wings of a butterfly right now. And you'll have one more just like that. Inhale. Exhale. So we draw those elbows back again. Think about lifting your chest. As you lift your chest, your gaze will lift. So you're looking straight ahead with those elbows pulling away from the wall that you're facing. Take one more breath here and extend your arms straight back. So your goal right now is to take the hands away from your tailbone, relax your shoulders, take one more inhale breath here, and as we exhale, we're gonna bend our knees slightly and then slowly start to hinge from our hips, pulling those hands away from our hips, relaxing your head, and now try to drop your chest to your thighs. And as you drop your chest to your thighs, you're trying to squeeze your elbows in towards one another and allow those hands to drop towards the back of your head. Take one more long inhale breath here, and as we exhale, dropping the hands to your tailbone, let those hands slide down to the floor. With your next inhale breath, we're coming into that flat back again. So hands can be on shins if we need. And as we exhale, hands are gonna come back down to the floor in your high push-up. As we step or jump back, shoulders right over your wrist. Option to drop your knees right now, or we bend the elbows to our low push-up. Inhale, dropping the toenails, the knees, upward facing dog, keeping the knees on the floor or floating those knees and really rolling the shoulders down and back. Take a long inhale breath here. And as we rock back, find your downward facing dog. Take two deep cleansing breaths here, in through the nose and out through the nose. And one more here, in through the nose and out through the nose. And with your next inhale breath, softly bend your knees. And as we look forward, one foot will step forward, the other foot will follow. And now bend both knees, bend both elbows, and just soften your head, your gaze, your neck. Little shake yes, little shake no if it feels better. And with your next inhale breath, find that flat back again. Roll the shoulders back, lift the chest. And our next inhale will take us all the way up to standing. And as we exhale, placing the hands right at our heart again. And I'll spin sideways again, just for illustration purposes. I'm gonna have you interlace those hands behind you again. But notice when you interlace, you always tend to put the same thumb in front. So I'm gonna have you switch. So I'll usually put left on top of right. So I'm gonna switch right on top of left. It'll feel a little different and odd to you. And as we look down to find our feet at hips distance apart again, we slide the hands, the knuckles, up towards the tag of your pants. And now relax the elbows, relax your gaze. And this probably looks like you're not in very good posture right now. But that's gonna allow your elbows to drop forward to open up the upper back. And with your inhale breath, you're gonna pull those elbows back away from the wall that you're facing, and now release. Inhale, pull the elbows away, and exhale, release. We've got one more just like that. Pull the elbows away from the wall, and now release.
This time, hold the elbows away from the wall. Keep the elbows here and try to extend the arms straight back. And as you extend it back, you're thinking about squeezing those elbows in, softening the tops of your shoulders. Keep everything you have right now and slowly lift the chest and lift the gaze. Take one more inhale breath here as we softly bend our knees. You're hinging forward, so your hips move back, your chest moves forward, your head follows along. Take one more inhale breath here and slowly drop chest towards your thighs and drop your gaze. You're looking right between your shins. Think about those elbows squeezing in still and think about the hands dropping towards the back of your head. Take a couple of breaths here, and every time we exhale, can you feel those hands dropping closer and closer to the floor overhead? At the end of your next exhale breath, lower the hands to your tailbone and let those hands slowly slide down to the floor. And as we inhale, coming into our flat back, hands on shins, hands on floor, whatever's accessible to you, roll the shoulders back. Take a long inhale breath here. Dropping our hands down to the floor, we step or jump back to your high push-up. Shoulders over wrists, elbows squeezing in, tucking our tailbone, pushing those heels back, keeping the upper body, keeping the lower body in one unit, trying to bend our elbows to your low hover. And as we inhale, dropping the toenails, dropping the knees, pressing into the mat evenly, finding our upward facing dog. And as we exhale, flipping those toes over to your downward facing dog. Take one more long inhale breath here. And at the end of the exhale breath, we're lowering down onto our knees. And as we come down onto the knees, we're gonna come down onto our elbows, hugging the elbows so they are shoulder distance apart, interlacing our hands, dropping the outer hands to the floor. We're gonna slowly rock forward, taking a look at our knees. We're gonna bring those knees completely together. Once we have them together, relax your gaze, take your right leg and extend your right leg straight back. Floating that right leg, we're gonna slowly take the right hip and open up the hip towards the right wall. Firm down into your forearms so we're not excessively rocking our weight from the right to the left. You're gonna kick yourself in the behind. And then take that right knee and pull it away from the floor. And now slowly drop your gaze to look at your left knee and try to open up that right hip away from the floor as much as you can. Take one more deep breath in here and slowly turn that right knee back into the floor, lower the right knee, reset into neutral, push down into both forearms. Now slide your left leg back. Floating that left heel, kick yourself in the behind, and then slowly, slowly open up this left hip to the left wall. And just notice the weight distribution in your forearms. We're trying to stay level between left and right. Dropping the gaze to your right knee, slowly peel that left hip any amount further away from that left wall. Take one more long breath here, rotating that hip and that knee, left knee, back onto the floor. And once we're back, lift the chest. Take one more long inhale breath here, keeping your elbows right underneath your shoulders, keeping your eye gaze right between the palms of your hands. Slowly walk your knees back. Some of us may choose to stay right here on our knees in a kneeling forearm plank. Some of you might tuck your toes underneath you, and as you lift your knees, press those heels back, pull the chest forward, holding for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Nice work. We're coming down. Ease back, but try to keep your elbows where they are. Walk your knees forward, and then slowly lift the tailbone, push into the forearms, and rock back. If the floor is accessible for you, the forehead is coming down. If not, allow your forehead to float. And we should feel a stretch right in your upper back, right between your shoulder blades. Take one more long inhale breath. At the end of our exhale, we're slowly gliding forward, placing our hands where our elbows were, crawling towards the front of your mat. And as you flip around to have a seat, I'm going to turn sideways for illustration purposes. I'm going to have you slowly recline onto your back. Once we come onto our back, keep your right foot on the floor, lift your left leg, and cross left ankle over right knee. Take that left knee and gently push it down to the floor. But notice your left foot. You want to flex your foot so your toes are pulled towards your shins. With your next inhale breath, keep pushing the left knee slightly away from you, and take that right leg and slowly bring the right leg towards your right shoulder. If you need a belt, feel free to grab a belt or a towel to put right behind the back of your right knee. If it's difficult for you to interlace your hands, that's when the belt or strap can help you, and you can hold on to both ends of your belt or strap. But if you can interlace your hands, put it right underneath the back of your right knee. Drop the right foot, let it dangle. And as you gently pull the right knee towards your right shoulder, take this left knee and push it away from you. And then start to notice, is your lower back on the floor? So take a few breaths and see if you can gently lift your lower back away from the floor. So you're arching your back away from the floor. Think about lifting the chest towards the wall that's overhead. And think about pushing the left knee towards the wall that's underneath you now. And gently pulling the right knee a little bit to the right, your figure four. Take one more breath here. And as we exhale, we're going to lower this right foot. Once you lower the foot, move your right foot a little to the left. Take your left knee and cross left knee over right knee. So once you have knee over knee, bring your arms parallel to your shoulders. Push down into your right foot so your hips come off the floor. Swing your hips to the left, so we always swing it to the top leg, which is your left. And as you look left, get a nice tight cross of your left knee over your right knee, and gently allow both knees to drop towards your right. A little spinal twist. Take a few breaths here. The goal is to keep the left shoulder and left arm down, and allow both knees to drop as far to the right as we can. At the end of your next exhale breath, you're going to slowly bring your knees back to center. And as we arrive back to center, you're going to uncross left from right. Press down just enough to swing your hips back to the middle of your mat. And once you're back at center, you're going to leave your left foot on the floor, pick up your right foot, and cross right ankle over left knee, pushing this right knee away from you, and checking that your foot is completely flexed. So flexed foot is all five toes pulling straight back to your shin, as opposed to the big toe coming towards your face, which is what we call a sickle foot. So that's not what you want. So pull all five toes back, ankle over knee, and gently push the right knee away from you. You can even use your right hand to assist with that. Using our hands, a belt, or a strap, we're going to slowly draw the left knee towards your left shoulder. Interlace the hands right underneath, so notice you might have to curl your tailbone up to get the leg in, so totally fine to do that. Drop the left heel, just let it dangle, and now slowly push the thighs away from you, and think about lifting your lower back off the floor. So if you lift your lower back off the floor, you would feel the backs of your shoulder blades pressing down, you'll feel the back of your hips pressing down, and you'll feel like the legs are moving slightly away from you, and your hands lassoed underneath that left knee is preventing both legs to move away from you. Okay, gently take your left knee, slide it a little to the left, but push your right knee down towards the wall that's beneath you now. Take one more long inhale breath here, feeling the stretch on the outside of the right hip. As we lower the left foot to the floor, move your left foot a little bit over to the right. Then cross the right knee over the left knee, moving the left foot slightly in towards your behind. Bring both arms parallel to the floor and push down into your left foot to pick up your hips. Once your hips are airborne, swing to the right and then lower both hips down. And as you try to cross your right leg tightly over the left leg, Readjust and think about taking your right ankle and squeezing it towards your left shin. As you look to the right, dropping both shoulders down to the floor, slowly drop both knees to the left. So the goal is to keep the right arm and the right shoulder down on the floor. And just notice while you're here, when you exhale, do you find that your thighs and your knees gently drop a little bit more to the left without letting your right arm and right shoulder rise? At the end of your exhale breath, both knees are going to come back to the center, back to the ceiling. Uncross right leg from left leg. Press down just enough to lift your hips and swing your hips back to the left, lowering back down. Once you lower down, move your feet out away from each other and let your knees gently go side to side. So I call this a windshield wiper when your knees drop side to side. And as you begin to walk your feet in towards one another, so they're hips distance apart, walk your feet slightly back, walk your arms underneath you, so I'm rocking side to side to get the arms to tuck underneath me with my palms on the floor, gently tuck your chin, press into your feet to lift your hips, and squeezing your knees slightly inwards without them touching, both feet are firmly flat on the floor, press into the floor, find your leg bridge, breathing for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, gently tilt your tailbone towards the knees, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower all the way down. And once you lower down, separate your arms slightly away from your hips, flipping the palms to the ceiling, drop the back of the hands to the floor. Take one leg, as you extend the leg straight, bring it slightly out diagonally in that direction. So if it's your right leg, it's going a little bit to the right. Same with the left leg. Lengthen the leg and let both big toes drop out to the corners. And notice right now, you might be arching your back away from the floor. You might be tilting your tailbone up and smashing your low back into the floor. So split the difference so you have a natural curve in your spine. If this bothers your lower back, feel free to both place both feet on the floor and let the knees fold in towards one another and your toes turn in. So this is very soothing to the lower back. Wherever you decide to place your legs or your feet, soften your shoulders. And then notice whether or not the lower part of your neck is pressed into the floor, or you might have your chin a little bit higher than your forehead. So if you need a block or a pillow, support your head, say your chin and your forehead are roughly parallel to the floor. Close your eyes and allow your breath to soften. Let go of the shoulders, let go of your muscles, let go of your bones. Allow your body to receive the benefits of the work you just performed. Allow the lower jaw to release from your upper jaw. And now let go of any tension you might be holding right across the top of your forehead. Staying here for as many breaths as you would like. At the end of your exhale breath, placing some small movements into your fingers, into your toes. And if your legs are straight, begin to slide your feet in towards your behind. If your feet are already on the floor, heel toe your feet so they're hips distance apart. You can allow your knees to gently sway side to side here, or slowly draw your knees to your chest and allow those knees to sway. And one of these side-to-side sways will allow you to roll to one side, and you pick the side. So as we roll over to one side, take your bottom hand, make a fist, so you can elevate your ear off the floor so your spine's more neutral. Take one more breath here. And when you're ready, use your arms to help you come up. And as you come up, try to find a seated position on your mat. So if sitting cross-legged is uncomfortable, feel free to sit however you'd like. And once you find yourself seated, lift your sternum, roll the shoulders away from the wall that you're facing, either placing your hands at the tops of your knees or at your heart center. Take one more deep breath in. And as we slowly bow down towards our fingertips. And at the end of your exhale breath, thank you for joining me. Namaste.